Okay, so Jabra are back with their new Enhance Pro 30s, available exclusively in Costco US. And in all honesty, I don't know why more people aren't talking about them. In my opinion, the Enhance Pro 20s, which were their 2023 model, left some room for improvement. So it's exciting to see that there is a brand new design, there is a new sound, and a whole host of new features for improved speech understanding in background noise. But also, there's a new price. We'll get there. The big question is, what are Philips, Sennheiser or Rexton going to do now that Jabra have superseded their Enhance Pro 20s with not one, but two new fully loaded hearing aids? These things are AI powered, they are Auracast-ready and one of the smallest hearing aids currently on the market. First of all, we have the RIE 13, which features a multifunction button and uses a size 13 disposable battery that you'll need to change roughly once a week. Secondly, there's the Micro RIE, which Jabra are boasting is the world's smallest hearing aid featuring artificial intelligence. It sports a push button rather than the multifunction button that we see on the disposable battery version and houses a lithium-ion rechargeable battery, providing up to 30 hours of battery life per charge, which is a 25% improvement in battery life versus the Enhance Pro 20s. You'll notice that there's still a typical receiver-in-canal style of hearing aid, meaning that the hearing aid itself sits behind your ear with a thin wire sending information and energy down to the speaker, which sits inside your ear canal. Now, I know that there'll be a small percentage of you today that are watching this video interested in knowing about custom-made versions of these hearing aids, so an in-the-ear version. But I have to say, to date, there is currently no word on the release of one. And if history is anything to go by, then it's pretty unlikely too. Saying that, I do personally try to encourage as many patients as possible that certainly come through my doors to opt for a receiver-in-canal style over an in-the-ear style. Very simply put, because it will give you access to far more features when you go with a behind-the-ear hearing aid, which we'll come on to shortly. As far as physical developments go, the microphones have also had a redesign, which realistically isn't going to be that big in terms of improving the sound, but should have a positive impact in terms of robustness, meaning that the new microphone covers will prevent debris ingress and can be changed by you at home or in clinic, rather than needing to be sent back to Jabra HQ if there's a fault with them. And of course, I am all for anything that makes your experience with hearing aids far more seamless. I've got a couple more physical developments that are worth running through now, and then I'll run through some of Jabra's new features. So, the charger. Well, the charger is a beast. It's great, but in my opinion, it still needs a little bit of work. As I mentioned earlier, a single charge will give you a full 30 hours of battery life, which is reduced to around 25 hours if you utilize the streaming features, which I'll come onto in more detail later on in today's video. As you would hope, Costco provide these hearing aids with the premium portable charger, meaning that it has a built-in lithium-ion battery, which is great if you're away from home and don't always want to worry about having access to a power source. There is a downside to this though, and it may just be me being picky, but it is heavy, it's huge, and for its sole purpose being travel, it's not really built with travel in mind. And I think the Jabra are missing a trick in my opinion, and there would definitely be a market for a charger with an extra day of charge, not necessarily 3 to 5, and it could be built a lot smaller in that case. Just something to bear in mind if there's anybody from Jabra HQ watching who could have an influence on this. Now, normally Costco are pretty limited in terms of colours, so I'm pleased to share on this occasion that you have the option of sparkling silver, sand, bronze and deep black to choose from. Each option is matted so they don't tend to catch the light, and I would recommend that you go for something that matches your hair colour as it will be far more discreet. Now, for those of you that haven't watched my videos before, just to give you an idea of the format of my videos, this video today is a launch video, sharing everything that there is to know so far about this brand new technology. But I'm pretty unique in this space, in the YouTube space, in the fact that you won't see a detailed review from me until they've been in a few patients' ears and I can offer legitimate feedback other than my own opinion and the opinion of the manufacturers. So if you want to see the detailed version of this video, then you'll find the subscribe button somewhere down here. And so it's worth a press if you want to be notified as soon as the detailed version is released. Saying that, there is still masses of content to cover today. So here's a list of the features built into both of these new models. And you'll recognize some old and some new, like the likes of the 17 channels of warp compression, DFS Ultra 3, and a host of noise reduction settings. More importantly, you will see that there are some major differences, other than the battery power, between the Micro RIE and the RIE 13. And these are around the tap control and noise reduction and speech understanding features. So make sure that you talk to your hearing aid dispenser about which is the most appropriate for you. If you want my opinion, I would personally go for the rechargeable option every single time. Now, in all technology, that's not just hearing aids now, there are limits to the computational power of a single chip. And so what do you do if you hit that limit? Well, Jabra have followed the likes of Resound and Phonak, and they've added a second chip, introducing their first dual chip architecture, which means that this new technology is 17 times more efficient than the Enhance Pro 20s and achieves a whopping 4.9 trillion operations per day, which is 12 zeros in case you were wondering. So the first chip, the 360 chip, features what Jabra describe as the industry's most accurate real-time environmental classification system, which constantly scans your environment and adjusts itself to your specific listening situation. So in reality, the hearing aids activate the right features at the right time. And if you think about it, it's really what you want from a hearing aid that knows if you're in noise, quiet, watching the television, etc., etc. And then running on top of the 360 chip, acting as a filter to create a greater contrast between unwanted noise and speech, Jabra have their deep neural network, which is a form of artificial intelligence. Now, Jabra are utilizing this DNN, which has been trained using 13 million sentences and 3.9 million sound parameters, may I add, to power multiple new features, all aimed around better speech understanding in background noise. The holy grail for anybody out there with hearing loss. Now, they're calling their AI noise reduction feature Intelligent Focus. Their directional beamforming feature is called Clear Focus, which is their unique, kind of unique feature, which is designed to enhance speech in front of you. And then finally, their 360 all-round feature, which is designed specifically to maintain your spatial awareness, which for any of you non-techie folks out there means it's aiming to keep you connected with the sounds in the world around you, whilst simultaneously ensuring that they're just not that bit too much intrusive, so they don't have too much of a negative impact in you hearing the person that's in front of you. So I think it's safe to say that we've seen a huge amount of developments over their predecessors. I know they sound great, but the big question is, are these hearing aids suitable for you? Yes, as long as you have a hearing care provider that knows how to get the best out of them. What I mean by that is they'll need to be physically adjusted in two different ways to be able to meet your needs. Of course, that's on top of adjusting them acoustically. Both the Micro RIE and the RIE 13 are compatible with a range of different receivers, meaning that your hearing care provider can physically change the power level to suit your hearing loss. In reality, this means that whether you have a mild, moderate, severe, or profound hearing loss, they could technically be suitable for you. So if your hearing loss falls within the grey shaded area of any of these graphs, then that's technically the most appropriate speaker for you and your hearing loss. As well as changing the power of that receiver, the way that the hearing aids are coupled to your ears can be personalized too, with a selection of medical grade silicone domes to choose from or various custom tips. Custom tips do come in at an extra cost in Costco, but if you need them, please, I'm begging you, do not look to save the cash. It's something like $40 per ear off the top of my head. Now, I'm saying this because I want to put a bit of emphasis on this part of today's video more than anything else that I'm covering today. As believe it or not, the tip on the end of your hearing aid is incredibly important. And all too often, I see hearing aid users lost in online forums looking for guidance on the most appropriate tip for them. And if that's you, I feel incredibly sorry for you, as that's the job of your hearing care professional, not you. The wrong tip can completely transform the way that your hearing aid sounds, from how much clarity it provides, how well it copes in background noise, how good it sounds when you're streaming, for example, and also comfort. And I will always try, personally, to put a custom tip on as many people's ears as possible, well, as many hearing aid users' ears as possible when they're appropriate. Hopefully, by empowering you with this information, this will get you to ask the right questions regarding your configuration when you go to see your hearing aid dispenser. Yes, you can believe your eyes. You did indeed, and you should see here somewhere, Auracast on that list of features built into the Enhance Pro 30s. But I guess you're tired of me talking about it in all of my other videos now, and I'm tired of talking about it too. Because whilst every manufacturer is boasting that they've built it into their latest technology, yes, that's you, Oticon, Philips, Starkey, Widex, Signia, Rexton, Sennheiser, Phonak, or anybody else that I've missed, Jabra are the only manufacturers, along with ReSound, to have actually rolled it out. And it works. I'm not joking. I've used it. I've even got an Auracast transmitter built into our clinic, which means that the brand new Auracast Assistant, which is built into the Jabra Enhance Pro app, lets you share and switch between broadcast audio streams with a very simple press of a button. Meaning that if you want to tune into an airport announcement, a museum presentation, or even a concert, this will be easier than ever. So if you want to try Auracast technology out, come and visit me in clinic. Auracast works alongside the regular phone connectivity that we saw in the Enhance Pro 20s. And for those of you that are unfamiliar with the advantages of connecting your phone to your hearing aids, this is via Bluetooth, it's worth knowing about the two main bonuses, the two main benefits, let's say. So firstly, it allows you to stream any audio from your phone to your hearing aid. So if you're taking a phone call, watching me on YouTube, or listening to the radio, music, or a podcast, the sound will be wirelessly sent from your phone to your hearing aids, and of course, taking into account your hearing test results too. The second advantage is that you'll have access to the Jabra Enhance Pro app, which gives you access to a ton of features which have been inherited from their previous model. And I'm talking about the sound enhancer, tinnitus manager, the check my fit feature, to the live assist and remote fine tuning, all of which I'll cover in great detail in my full review of these hearing aids down the line. Price-wise, these are available in Costco for $1,699.99, which is $100 dearer than the Enhance Pro 20s and should be available in all Costcos from May 2025. Now, I hope that's enough to whet your appetite, but I would not go out and buy them until you've watched this video comparing the best hearing aids for 2025.